On, I had an opportunity to visit Kerry in his home. And here's that interview.
Well, this is a crutch. This is the thing that Al Madrill used to bang around on Kerry Von Erich's leg when he and Al Madrill and Brian Adias had their confrontation recently. We'll talk about that in a little later on, Kerry. But what really bothers me is, after a lifelong friendship, Brian Adias and you, starting out in junior high school, grade school, actually, and playing football, all this, what has happened to change Brian Adias? Why has he suddenly turned on you?
Well, I'll tell you, Bill, you know, first of all, it's quite obvious that it's Brian's lips are moving, Al Madrill doing all the talking. Al Madrill's made his life seem just so elaborate and great to Brian, talking about new cars, new homes, all that. Sure, that's nice, but you sure can't sell a friendship for it. You know, a lot of people are wondering why I stepped into the ring with Brian that night.
You took a chance, yeah.
Well, yeah, but to me it wasn't a chance. Right. Because Brian and I, we went to elementary school, like you said. Junior high, played football side by side. High school, and then we went to college. He went his way, I went mine. Well, then I came into professional wrestling, promising I'd bring Brian into professional wrestling. Well, Brian came and we brought him to Dallas. He became the sixth man world champions with us. He became the American champion with me, tag team. Well, hey, why wouldn't I step into the ring with this guy? Al Madrill, 4 or 5 years ago when he left, he and I left on handshaking terms. And so why wouldn't I step into that ring? But that night, it was obvious. It was Brian's lips moving. Everything Al Madrill had built into Brian's head came out that night. But I'll tell you what, it's nothing's more disappointing than having a friend in the ring, Al Madrill coming down on me, doing this with his crutch.
Smashing it.
And Brian standing right there and watching. I remember looking at Brian, standing there watching. I'll tell you what, Brian, you know better than anybody. You don't mess with the Von Erichs. You know that more than anybody would know that, because you are like a brother to me. Well, I'll tell you what happens from here on out, it isn't my fault. It isn't Kevin's fault. It isn't Mike's fault. It's your fault. And I'm not going to pull the horses back either. And we're going full speed on you, Brian. And I'll tell you what, Al Madrill, what you've done is totally unexcusable.
It's really unethical.
You know, the injury done on this leg.
Yeah, what about it
before,
now?
Before, it was almost to the point where I almost had to have my leg amputated. Now my leg is back. It's coming on strong. But then in Fort Worth that night, Al Madrill bent in this crutch over it, hitting it so many times. I was lucky I had a brace on it that night. Because if I wouldn't have, he would have re-broke my leg and probably put me back way before I was when it happened in the beginning. Well, I am coming back. Sure, it's a setback. But I'll tell you what, Bill, and you people out there, I may not be able to wrestle for a little bit longer now. I will be back, but maybe a little longer I'll be out. But nothing is going to stop me from being at the ring with my brother Mike. If I've got to manage him, I will. If I've got to be at the ring with Kevin, I will, because everything I know. And they will know how to handle you, Brian and Al Madrill, because you guys are finished.
Kerry, good luck to you. I'm sorry you got a setback on this, but knowing your tenacity, it's not going to be one of those things that we can wait for very long.
All right, Bill, I will be back. It's a setback. We don't know how long, maybe 2 weeks, maybe a month. But I will be back. I'll be back.
Kerry Von Erich, as we talk about that attack by Al Madrill and Brian Adias. And we'll be back with more of World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
You're nothing, Von Erich. You've never been nothing, and you never will, baby.
No, that's it. You son of a bitch, I'll tell you what.
Take it easy with Kerry, please. Hey, take it easy. Oh!
Mike, Kevin, now you saw the interview with Kerry. We know what's happened. You know what has occurred. What's on your mind now as you think of Al Madrill and Brian Adias?
Well, you know, it's not fit for television what's on my mind, but I'll tell you this. Kerry's comeback has definitely been hindered. Let me tell everyone in Israel, Japan, all around the world, Kerry will definitely be back. We were looking at a couple of months. I don't know what we're looking at now. But let me tell you this. Madrill and Brian Adias, this will not go unpunished. What you do to one Von Erich, you do to all of us. Now, when I watched that crutch bend around my little brother's foot, I know what you wanted. You want a main event match, and you risked my baby brother's career for it. Now, I've stuck up for my baby brother all of my life, and my baby brother now is 260 pounds, but it still ain't no different. When I get in the ring with you, Al Madrill, it's not to win a match. It's not to beat you. It's to hurt you. I'm going to hurt you, and I'm going to cripple your leg, and both everybody in my family feels the same way.
Mike, it goes the same way for me, Brian Adias. First you turn on me, then you turn on my family, and then you turn on my brother Kerry when he was at his most, when he was the most hurt. You turned on him and you turned on all the fans. You and Al Madrill, both of you are going to pay heavy. We're not going to let this get away. We're not going to let anyone get away with hurting either any of us.
You heard what he said. He said, all we wanted was a main event match. I never got to wrestle the Von Erich boys. Well, let me tell you something. You're going to wrestle one of the Von Erich boys, all right.
All right, let's get the cut. Lance, over here.
You know, it makes me sick what Brian Adias and Al Madrill did to Kerry, and also makes me sick that Brian Adias has the gall to turn on us like that. Yeah. You know, I've gone every place with him together. We were good friends, and he turned on us. And let me tell you something. Al Madrill, Brian Adias, you're going to pay. You're going to pay bad.
I'm sure it's a surprise to you guys that Brian did this. I mean, it just doesn't make sense.
Yeah,
after all
a real surprise, but let me just add this. I never really loved the guy anyway. I'm not just spilling my guts, but I'll tell you something. Brian, I've known him since I was a baby, just a little kid. Kerry treated him like gold. I always felt like he just hung around with Kerry just so he could be... When I get Brian, I just can't wait to get my hands around his neck. Just one match, that's all I ask. Any time, any building, any place. Al Madrill, Brian Adias, just give me a match.
Okay, fellas, thank you, Mike.
I know you've never seen my brother like that before or my cousin. But we're the worst. This is the worst I've ever felt about anybody in my whole life. Brian Adias, Al Madrill, anyone else who steps in there and tries anything else with my brother, Kerry, you're going to pay too.
Okay, Mike, Kevin, and Lance. I think the debt is to be paid. And certainly these guys are capable of doing it. We'll be right back with our next bout, which happens to be Al